Good morning, students. Welcome to the class of physics. So today we will continue our previous topic, the equation of motion. So we already talked about the first equation of motion that gives us the relationship between velocity and the time. So from the equation, so as we know that first equation of motion is defined as v equals to u plus at, and with the help of the velocity time graph we calculated the value or the expression v equals to u plus at. So today we will talk about our next equation of motion, that is the second equation of motion. So second equation of motion is also defined, which gives us the relationship between position and the time. That's why this equation of motion is also defined as position-time relation or second equation of motion. In mathematical form, we express the equation s equals to ut plus half at square, where s equals to distance or the displacement, equals to u initial velocity, t for the time, into 1 by 2 into a. A for the acceleration of the object and t for the time. So we have to now calculate the expression for the second equation of motion, that is s equals to ut plus half at square. So in the topic, one thing is common, we are only having one graph to calculate the expression of motion for all three equations of motion. That means from the very first graph, we can calculate or we will calculate the all the equations of motion. So now we will start our next equation of motion. So by the graph, as we know that x-axis defines the time and y-axis defines the velocity axis. So object will having some initial velocity u will move with the uniform acceleration and our slope is from A to B. So by the previous topics, so as we know that by the previous lecture we already talked about some velocity, some graph relationship that covers that whenever we want to calculate the value of the distance from the velocity time graph. So how will we calculate the value of the displacement or the distance covered by the object? Whatever amount of the area covered by the graph, that amount of area will give us the value of the magnitude of the displacement or the value of the distance covered by the object. That means if we calculate the area under the graph, our graph is starting from, if we calculate the area under the curve, area under the graph AB, so that area will give us the distance covered by the object. So children, always remember one thing, our graph is only from A to B. This portion of B is our additional construction in the equation or in the diagram to calculate the mathematical expression. This part is not covered, considered as the part of the graph. So if we calculate, the area under the slope A to B, so that area will give us the value of the distance. So now the question is that how will we calculate the area under the slope AB? So we have to calculate the total area from OABC, because our graph is starting from O, that is defined as the initial position. From this point it will gain some initial velocity. So O, we have to cover the area under the graph That means the area under AO, AB, CO. This closed area will give us the value of the distance covered by the object. Now, how will we calculate the area, total area under covered by this slope? So, we will split that whole area into the two parts. So, by the graph, as shown in the graph, that is, we are having the graph in the two parts. That means one figure is considered as a triangle and one part is considered as the rectangle. So, to calculate area under the graph, what will we do? We will split the whole area into the two parts. Area under the triangle or area under the rectangle. And when we add these both areas, so we will get the value of the whole area under the graph. Now, the equation, second equation of motion will start from S, total area enclosed under the graph. S equals to total area enclosed. S equals to, that means distance, equals to, how will we calculate the distance? Area enclosed under the graph. So, how will we calculate the area under the graph? This S distance will be equals to the very first area of the rectangle under the graph plus area of the triangle ABD. So, what is the rectangle and what is the triangle? This OADC will be our rectangle and this ABD will be our triangle. So, if we calculate the area of this triangle and this rectangle and finally we add both areas, then we will get the value of the whole area enclosed under the slope AB. Whole area enclosed under the slope AB. Now, by the formula, as we know that S equals to area of the rectangle. So, by the formula of the area of the rectangle, as we know that length into breadth will give us the value of the area of the rectangle plus area of the triangle. So, that is the right angle triangle. So, area of the triangle is considered as 1 by 2 into base into height. So, we will calculate these values from the graph. So, very first, area of the rectangle is calculated as any of the one side, that is we can take OA or we can take CD. Any of the value, both are the opposite side, so both will be the same. So, you can take any one. So, if you are taking OA into this value, length, that is AD. So, AD will always be equals to the OC because both are the equal and opposite sides. So, we can take AD or OC. Now, we will take the multiplication of the length into breadth. So, our length will be equals to the AB, AD and breadth will be equals to the OA. So, the multiplication of the AD into OA will give us the area of the rectangle. Now, area of the triangle. So, this ABD will define as the triangle and this triangle is treated as the right angle triangle because the angle ADB is the 90 degree. That's why this triangle is defined as the right angle triangle. So, by the formula of the right angle triangle, as we know that 1 by 2 into base into height. Now, from the diagram, what will be the base of the triangle? AD will be the base of the triangle. And what will be the height of the triangle? This BD will be the height of the triangle. So, the multiplication of 1 by 2 into AD into BD will give us the value of the area of the triangle. Now, we will place all the values in the equation. So this will be AD into OA, that is area of the rectangle, and 1 by 2 AD into BD, this will be the area of the 1 by 2 AD into BD will be the area of the triangle. Now the last step is to put all the values in the equation. Now from the diagram we can calculate the values of all those. So if we talk about the area of the rectangle, the what will be the value of the AD? What will be the value of the AD? This much amount, 0 to T, object covers any of the distance or any of the distance in time T. So the value, this value A to D, or we can write down this as the value of O to C. And this value O to, from O to C is termed as the value of the time taken during the journey of the object. Time taken by the object during the journey. So whatever amount of the value we will get of the OC, that will be the same amount for the value of the AD, because both are the same equal and opposite side. That means OC will be equals to the AD, and that will be having the value T of the time. Now what will be the value of the OA? So this value is starting from the O and it will move up to the point A, and then object will get some initial velocity u. So the magnitude of this OA will be treated as the value of the initial velocity of the object. So the value of the OA will be equals to the u. We already mentioned all these values in the first equation. So you will go through the first equation for the values. Now then you will get all the values from the diagram. Now the value of the OA will be equals to the magnitude of the initial velocity, or we can take the value of the initial velocity. So AD into AO, that means U into T. After that, for the values of the area of the triangle, 1 by 2 base into height. So what will be the base value? AD. So as the same, we are already having the value of the base, that will be equals to the T. And after that, the value of the BD. In the previous equation, or then the first equation of motion, we already calculated the value of the BD. So BD will be treated as the change in velocity. So what will be the value of the BD? B minus U, that is the final velocity minus initial velocity. After that, we will place all the values, that is BD will be treated as the A into T. From the equation, BD will be equals to the change in the velocity. So if we place the value in the equation, so A will be equals to the change in velocity upon the time. So change in velocity is represented by BD. So at the place of change in velocity, we will place the value of the BD. So A will be equals to the BD upon T, that is BD will be equals to the A into T. So these all values you will get from the first equation of motion. So no need to calculate this value again for the second equation of the motion. We can directly write down the value from the first equation of the motion. So after putting all the values, so S will be equals to the U into T plus half A into T into A into T, that is the value of the BD. So when we simplify the equation, so we can have the value UT plus half AT square. This is our second equation of motion, and this is also known as the position time relation, because we are having the value of the position or the value of the distance from the equation, and we are having the value of the time to calculate the values. So from this equation, if you are having any of the two values, so we can have the value of the third term or the third quantity. So if you are having the value of the U, T and A, so we can have the value of the S. If you are having the value of the S, U, T, so we can have the value of the A from the equation. Now the last equation of motion, the third equation of motion, and this is also known as the position velocity relation. So third equation of motion, और द पोजिशन वेलोसिटी इज रिलेशन इन मैथमेटिकल फॉर्म इज गिवन बाय द इक्वेशन v स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू u स्क्वायर प्लस 2as. So where v is the final velocity of the object, u is the initial velocity of the object, plus 2 into a is the acceleration of the object, s will be the position, or we can define as the path length or the distance of the object. To calculate the third equation of motion, we will again move to our graph, and from the graph, as we know that if we want to calculate the distance traveled by the object or the position of the object, so what will we do? We will directly calculate the area under the graph, or area enclosed within the graph. Now, that is, in the third equation of motion, we will not split the whole graph into the two parts. What will we do? We are having the shape like this, OABCO. This is our area enclosed under the graph. So what is the shape of the graph? That is also defined as the trapezium. So how will we calculate the area of the trapezium? So area of the trapezium. To calculate the area of the trapezium, we are having the formula. Directly we are having the formula to calculate the area. Area of the trapezium OABC will be equals to the sum of the parallel side divided by 2 into height. Sum of the parallel side divided by 2 into height. This is the formula to calculate the area of the trapezium. Always remember the formula to calculate the area of the trapezium. Sum of the parallel side divided by 2 into height. Sum of the parallel side divided by 2 into the height. So now by the diagram we will find out what are our parallel side and what will be our height. So this, what are our parallel sides? Parallel sides are those two sides, or those two lines which will never meet in the after moving some of the many of the finite or infinite distance. So from the diagram, as we see that OA and BC are our two parallel sides. That are under the area enclosed. We will not take OE is parallel to BC, because this part A is not under the area. The only part under the area is OA. Our graph is starting from OABC. That's why we will take the height of the parallel side for this y-axis is OA only, not the whole value OE. Got it? Because this part AE is not under the area of the graph. So for the parallel side, we will take OA and BC are our parallel side. Now what will be the height? This OC will be treated as the height of the trapezium. This OC will be treated as the height of the trapezium. We will not take BC as the height of the trapezium. What will we take? We will take OC as the height of the trapezium. OA, BC, both are the parallel side, and OC is the height of the trapezium. So by the diagram, we can write down here OA plus BC by 2, sum of the parallel side divided by 2 into OC will be the height. Now what will be the value of the AO? From the diagram or from the above written values, we can directly see from the equation number 1, all the values given in the equation number 1, OA will be equals to the U plus BC will be equals to the V. So U plus V divided by 2 into what will be the value of OC? That is the T. Now we will solve the equation. To solve the equation, what will we do? We will replace some of the values from the equation number 1 of the T. Now, from the since as we know that from equation number 1, V will be equals to the U plus AT. Now, we will separate the value of the T from the equation. So, we can write down V minus U equals to A into T. So, we can write down V minus U upon A equals to T. This will be A in the multiplication to the right side. So, this will be in the divide to the left side. So, V minus U upon A equals to the T. Now what will we do? We will place the value of the T in equation number 1. So what will we do in the next step? We will place putting value of equation A. What is the equation A? This is the equation A. in equation 1. So when we place the value, we are already having u plus v by 2, and from the equation we can replace the value of the t from the equation number a, that is v minus u upon a. Now v plus u by 2 into v minus u upon a. So this will give us the formula of a plus b, a minus b. So we will summarize the formula, that is a plus b into a minus b will be treated as a square minus b square. So we can write down from the equation, this will be treated as the a, that is b square minus u square upon 2 into a will be remain as it is in the multiplication. Now we will again simplify to the next step of the equation, that is b square minus u square equals to 2as. So this we can again simplify the equation to the next step also. V square can be written as, this will be to the left side in the negative, so this will be treated as a positive to the right side. So V square will be equals to the U square plus 2as. This is our third equation of motion. I hope you all will get the equation, all the equations of the motion, because these equation of the motion is very important part of our chapter. So all of you just do the equations of the motion very seriously for your exams also. That's all for today. Thank you.